You see, the most powerful thing we possess is ability to think for ourselves, the knowledge. And there are lots of issues that we've touched on today, which if you understand it properly, in a sensible manner, that can give you a better handle on reality. This is what Dharma is all about. Coming to terms with this reality, including this idea of reincarnation, all these things that we come across in a rational manner, in a sober manner, in a sensible manner. Once you do that, then you are safe and your religion is safe. When I come to Hindu society, they say, Mr. Lakhani, we must, you know, protect and promote our religion, dharma. I say, wonderful, my boy. How will you do it? If you don't understand it yourself, how will you do it? First, understand your dharma. Then you can protect it. If you don't understand, what are you going to protect? You don't know what you're protecting. Learn your religion in a structured, sensible manner. Use your own, not my, your common sense to make sense of what I'm saying or what religion is saying or Hinduism is saying. And I must make this warning to you. Finally, I'm going to stop now. You see, the two areas where you struggle are this. These are the external, superficial aspect of Hinduism, and yet they are necessary. I'm not saying they are bad. One is the narrative, colorful storytelling. I was brought to Hinduism because of my grandmother, and we used to tell me stories about Bhim, and I said, you love these stories. That's how I was brought to Hinduism, colorful storytelling. I know the exaggeration, but I just loved it, and I played with it. So narrative is a very important part of religion. Like, you know, in the modern society, Star Wars and, you know, Avatar and Harry Potter, there's a narrative. Same thing, how to be good and courageous and, you know, this is the same thing. We're using different narrative. So narrative is an important part of religion, but don't treat it as literal truth. Be very careful. So then you will get the scientists coming after you. Be rational. Recognize it as symbolic, as iconic, as narrative. That's one part you watch out. The second part where you watch out is this. When they ask you to do certain rituals, you light a divo and you sprinkle water and you offer flowers and fruit and all that and do aarti, understand what you are doing, what is the purpose behind it. Just don't do it mechanically. It loses all its meaning then. So the second aspect you watch out is rituals you do. Why are you doing? Not what you do, that we know what you do. You're already doing it. Why are we doing it? So the why question in the rituals and the issue of narrative, health warning. Once you know the health warning, you can take on any challenge. Once you know, this is, if you like, symbolic. It's a colorful way of presenting subtle ideas in religion. And they are, look, I'm not undermining them. I'm saying use them in the correct mode. See why you is necessary, why it's useful, and then you are safe.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism. Sponsored by People Care. Encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.